ride height sensors not only measure the position of the suspension, but also the rate of movement. They're supplied with a voltage of around 5 volts. The signal voltage is changed as a magnet moves past a coil. Most sensors have 3 wires: ground, power, and signal. Internally, it is difficult to damage one of these sensors. Externally, the linkage that connects the sensor to the suspension arm can also be damaged. The connector can be damaged and cause a short or open, and a code will be set. If one of these sensors is replaced, it must be calibrated after it's installed if the new part is going to work. Ride height sensors are sometimes called suspension position or wheel displacement sensors in the parts catalog. The data from the sensor is used to measure the movement of the suspension. By knowing how far and fast the suspension is moving, the module can use the information to determine the size of the orifice in the dampener to control compression and rebound. The module uses and shares information with the anti-lock braking system, engine control module, and instrument cluster. This information is typically shared on the high-speed CAN serial data bus. With all this information, the module can do some amazing things with the adjustable dampeners. Problems like nosedive, underbraking, torque steering, understeer can be minimized. If the vehicle has air ride, the volume and pressure inside the air springs can also be tuned along with the valving in the dampeners to optimize the ride quality and control. But if the input is missing from one or more ride height sensors, the system will go into a safe mode and limit the corrections to the dampeners. Thanks for watching.